Hi, I'd like to show you a very simple and cheap grow box that I made. This is not going to be an in-depth instructional video, but rather a demonstration on how I decided to make it, so you can hopefully get some ideas and inspiration for your project. I wanted to keep things as affordable as possible, so I used a regular cardboard box that I got from a local grocery store. It measures 25 by 30 by 50 centimeters. It's definitely on the smaller side, but it's ideal for having only one plant, which I currently do. Of course, you can make your bigger depending on the box you have. I flipped the box so it sits on one of its sides and cut off three of the overlaps. On the remaining longer overlap, I glued another piece of cardboard to serve as a door. Also, I cut off the top side so I can open it too. To get the sharp edge for the fold I made on the doors and the lid, you can cut through the first and the inner layer of the cardboard and bend it along the cut. Then, you take another strip of the outer cardboard layer and glue it on top of the first piece to secure the bend. I tried to use magnets to hold the door closed, but they weren't strong enough, so I used small pieces of Velcro instead. They proved to work great as they hold well and also allow for less precise alignment of the box sides. As far as covering corners where the light escapes, you can use some inside flaps or something, but I kinda like the way it currently looks, so I decided to leave it the way it is. To increase the efficiency of your light, you of course want to have reflective insides of the box. For that purpose, I used regular aluminum foil that I attached with a thin layer of universal glue. Now that we have the box, we need a way to hang the grow light inside. I used a simple rectangular wooden rod that I positioned on the back of the box. I held it in place with two zip ties, but you want to have one more piece of the wood on the outside, so the zip ties don't rest on the cardboard directly. To make attaching of the grow light easier, I offset the rod slightly using one more piece of the cardboard behind it. You can see I attached a small temperature and humidity sensor here, but since I plan to add some other functionalities in the future, I won't go into details now. To make things cheaper and more customizable, I picked up parts from the hardware store and made this simple cable with a plug and a switch. As a grow light, I'm using this cheap 40 LED bulb that I purchased from eBay. Now to attach the light to the wooden stand, I used these two metal profiles I had laying around. You can use some other system, but these turned out to be great because this bend allows you to rest on the stand and not slide down, while still being able to move up and down to set the height optimally. As an added feature, they can slide in and out, so it's possible to adjust the light position in one more dimension. I use zip ties to hold everything in place, but I didn't tighten them all the way, so everything can be adjusted as needed. That's pretty much it. One thing this box would benefit from is an air circulation system, which I plan to install in the future. In this setup, you won't have problems with excessive temperature since these LEDs don't put out a lot of heat, but if you want to make sure the humidity isn't too high, you can raise the lid a bit to allow for some passive air circulation. And there you have it, a simple but functional grow box that you can make for cheap by yourself. I hope this was helpful to you, and I wish you success with your future projects.